at the end of class on Wednesday, we ran out of time, and I just wanted to make sure that you had the opportunity to run through the graphing calculator stuff before the assessment next class. And so we were looking at this problem about pumpkin tossing. It says a pumpkin tossing contest is held each year in Morton, Illinois, where people compete to see whose catapult will send pumpkins the farthest. One catapult launches pumpkins from 25 feet above the ground at a speed of 125 feet per second. The table shows the horizontal distances in feet the pumpkins travel when launched at different angles. Use a graphing calculator to find the best fitting quadratic model for the data. In class, we had talked about how really one of the most important thing is, do you understand what the output and input are in this relationship? What is depending on what? So we had labeled the output as the distance the pumpkin has traveled in feet dependent on the angle that the pumpkin is launched in degrees. So we entered the data in the calculator, we set up a scatter plot, and we created a quadratic function that modeled the data. So now if we look at the questions that were asked on here, it says, what is the furthest distance a pumpkin traveled? So if we want the furthest distance a pumpkin has traveled, we're taking a look at, remember, this is the distance that the pumpkin has traveled dependent on the angle. And so if you don't understand that distance is your output, it's hard to understand, am I trying to find the vertex? Am I trying to find the x-intercept? Am I trying to find the y-intercept? Like, what is it that I need? And so again, it's really important to understand what is the output and what is the input. So if they ask me for the furthest distance, well, distance is my output. So I want the greatest output that I can find. So I go to my function. I want the coordinates of the vertex based off the function. And so if I want to find the vertex, I have to go second, calculate, maximum, because I'm looking for the maximum output, right? Concave down, maximum output. Concave up, it'd be the minimum output. And so I'm looking for the maximum output. Now it says left bound. It wants an input value that is to the left of the input that appears to be producing the maximum output. So I can either enter that numerically, or yes, I can move the cursor as long as I understand that every time I move the cursor, the input is changing. So right now I'm saying, I'm going to go over here and say, you know what? The input that's producing a maximum, you can start looking at an input of 24.4. I hit enter. See this little triangle right there? Say, this is the input that you start looking at. It says, where should I stop? Say, well, you can stop once you get to an input that's over here to the right of the vertex. I'm going to stop right there at an input of 57.44. See these two triangles? It's going to look at all of the input values between these two triangles and look at the outputs that are being produced and find the greatest output that's produced within that range of input values. It says, do you want to take a guess? Don't have to, but you could. You could say it looks like the input that's producing the maximum output is about 43.61. So it says actually it's at 43.207. Say, okay, that's the input that's producing the maximum output, 511.09. So again, those numbers don't mean anything to me unless I understand what the input and output of the relationship are representing. So I'm going to go to here. And visually, again, we just identified the coordinates of the vertex. And so we had this function, and goes like this, comes down. So we identified the coordinates of the vertex, and I wrote it down. It was 43.21 and 511.09. So what's that telling me? Well, this is the distance the pumpkin has traveled in feet. So the farthest distance that the pumpkin traveled in feet was 511.09 feet. And the angle that the pumpkin is launched from was 43.21 degrees. So apparently from their catapult, at least based off the function, if you launch the pumpkin at an angle of 43.21 degrees, you will have the pumpkin travel a distance of 511.09 feet. The next question said, at what angle did the pumpkin reach its maximum distance? We answer that question, 43.21 degrees. How far would a pumpkin travel at an angle of 36 degrees? 36 degrees is the angle, that is the input. Some of you still don't quite know how to find, if I give you an input, how do you find the output using your calculator? That is, again, the table of input-output values. So when I go to the table, your table might not look like this. I have my table set, second window. I like to keep my independent on ask. And that way, when I go to the table, it's waiting to know what I want the input to be. And it said the angle was 36 degrees, so I use an input of 36, and it says the output is 497.51. So 497.51 feet is my answer to this question. But I could write that algebraically, right, or function notation. If this was, my function was named f, I could say f of 36 is equal to whatever that output was. It was 497.51. 497.51. So in the context of the situation, if the pumpkin is launched at an angle of 36 degrees, it will travel a distance of 497.51 feet. Next question. If a pumpkin traveled 470 feet, what angle was used to launch the pumpkin? And so now they're giving me the output. If the pumpkin traveled 470 feet, what angle was used to launch the pumpkin? If I'm given an output and I want to find the input that produces an output of 470, unfortunately, there's not an easy way to just say, I want the output to be 470, tell me the input. We have to go to y equals. There's the function from the data. I have to graph y equals 470. Make sure you understand what your calculator will graph. It will graph a horizontal line, not a straight line. All lines are straight. A horizontal line. Will I see that horizontal line? Well, it would depend on my window. Since my y maximum goes to 600, I'll see that horizontal line. I had set my input to go from 0 to 100, and my output to go from 0 to 600, so I will see that horizontal line. Now, there are two angles that you could launch the pumpkin where it would travel a distance of 470 feet. So there's two answers to this question. I'm going to find this angle, the input that's producing an output of 470, second, calculate, intersect. It says, is this the function, the first function? Yes. Is y equals 470 the second one? Yes. Now, when it says take a guess, we usually go, oh, you don't have to. Well, there are two points of intersection. And so the cursor right now is closer to this point of intersection. So if I don't take a guess, it's going to go to this one. If I want to find this one, I will have to move the cursor over closer to the one that I'm looking for. So I'll hit enter. It says I found it. If the pumpkin is lodged at an angle of 30.67 degrees, according to the function, it will travel a distance of 470 feet. But that's not the only angle. So there's another angle you could launch the pumpkin at. So second, calculate, intersect. This is the first function. This is the second function. And I have to move my cursor over to find this one. There's also an angle of 55.74 degrees. The pumpkin will travel 470 feet. Now normally in this situation you'd want to find, or they'd ask you something about an x-intercept. And what would the x-intercept be communicating in this situation? Well, I guess if you found the x-intercept, that would be the angle that you launched the pumpkin where the pumpkin traveled no distance. So to me, I guess I'm thinking that would be like a 90 degree angle, basically. If you launch the pumpkin at a 90 degree angle, it should just come straight, pretty much straight back down and traveled no horizontal distance. So, but let's see what the function claims. Let's find that x-intercept. Should be around 90, I would think, logically. Now, to find the x-intercept, students often struggle if they're not looking at the x-axis right here. One of the ways you can always have the x-axis right in the middle of your screen is understanding that on your window, if your y-minimum and your y-maximum are the same value, but one's negative, the other's positive, then your x-axis is going to be right in the middle of your screen. So I'm going to go ahead and make my y-minimum negative 600. And I'm going to hit graph and see how the x-axis is right in the middle of the screen, and it makes it easy to identify this zero of the function, right? An input that produces an output of zero. The angle that you'd launch the pumpkin where it travels no distance. So I'm going to say second, calculate, zero, number two. And now we've got this left bound again. And so I already know that this goes from an input of zero to an input of 100. And I think that's around 90. So I'm going to say the left boundary is an input of 70. See the little triangle right here above an input of 70. And I'm going to say you can stop when you hit the right boundary when you hit an input of 95. See the triangle here? So it's going to look at all of the inputs from 70 to 95 and find me the input that's producing an output of zero. It says take a guess. Well, I think it's around 90. Enter. It says 87.4229. See how it got y equals negative 2e negative 11. That's scientific notation. That's negative point with 10 zeros and then a 2. That's really, really close to zero. If I chose different boundaries and did it again, it'd probably just say the output is zero. So I don't know if this makes real sense to me. It's what the function's claiming, because if I launch that pumpkin at 87.42 degrees, it seems like I should get some horizontal distance. I'd have to be launching it like straight up in the air, which would be a 90 degree angle, but I have to go with what the function said. So my answer to the question, well, they didn't ask the question, but the x-intercept would be communicating the angle you would launch the pumpkin at which there would be no distance, no horizontal distance from the catapult. What about the y-intercept? Well, I can always find the y-intercept. The y-intercept is the value of the output when your input is zero. So I could easily go to my table and say, when the input's zero, what's the output? And it says, well, the output is 23.029. If the situation, in this situation, what would our y-intercept be communicating? Not much. If we launch it at a 0 degree angle, we can't really launch the pumpkin at a 0 degree angle. That'd be like the catapult coming and just smashing it into the ground. That it supposedly would travel a distance of 23.029 feet. So that doesn't really make sense in the context of the situation, but you wouldn't be launching a pumpkin at an angle of 0 degrees. Right? We've talked about how sometimes certain mathematical things don't really necessarily make sense in the context of the situation, while others do. The vertex makes sense. Other points would make sense. The x-intercept was close. I think it should have been 90. Make sure you come in for the assessment and you know how to work your calculator. You know how to find maximums. You know how to find minimums. You know how to find y-intercepts. You know how to find x-intercepts. You know how to, given an input, find an output. You know how, given an output, to find the input. You'll have to do that on the assessment. Come see me if you have any questions.